Okay, wedging does a few things for your clay. This is called Japanese wedging. It works best for larger pieces, but it's difficult to teach without hands-on. What wedging does, it eliminates all the air bubbles in your clay. It wakes up the particles, gets it moving and soft, ready for the wheel, and it makes it homogeneous. There's no wet pieces or dry pieces. For the sake of this DVD, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about forward wedging. It does the same thing as the Japanese wedging, but in a smaller piece of clay. So to wedge a piece of clay, you want to put your hands directly out in front of you, this way, and then you put the palms or the heels of your hands in. And as I do that, I stand the clay up. He looks in my tummy, and my fingers are facing each other at the back of the clay. And then I'm going to pick it up. He's going to look at my tummy, and it's going to pivot on the balls of my middle finger. So you pick it up and down. Some people call this cowhead wedging, because if you look at him, if you give him eyes and little horns and a nose, kind of looks like a cow. Anyway, have him look at your tummy, roll it, and go around. You can tell if you're wedging properly by put a dent in the top of it with your thumb and watch that dent roll around and disappear. So now all the air is out of the clay. It's homogenized, it's woken up, and it's ready to make pots. Roll it out into a loaf. And what I like to do is when I'm wedging clay, I know what I'm going to make before I go on the wheel. And so I tell the clay. When we go on the wheel, we're going to make three cylinders. That's number one, number two, and number three. So I like to sort of pat them around. If you go onto the wheel and don't know what you're making, you are indecisive, the clay doesn't know what to do, go on there with a destination or a goal, and you'll have a better chance of reaching it. So we're going to go on the wheel, and we're going to make three cylinders.